Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Hi everybody, I'm going to be reading Lady's Eulogy from the website. I'm sorry I'm a little bit late. We had some technical difficulties getting the lives to work. Lady was rescued November 29th, 2019, and she passed away May 15th at the sanctuary. Her estimated age was 52 years old, and she was a former circus and zoo elephant. Lady wasn't your ordinary elephant. She had a spunk that resonated with everyone she met. That doesn't mean that she immediately took to all who knew her. You had to earn her trust, and it didn't come easily. Lady seemed to know her worth and insisted that you be present in the moment with her if you were going to be her caregiver. If she didn't like how you were approaching her, she'd bang her head against the bars as a warning that you needed to be truly there with her. When Scott first met Lady in the zoo, she'd been confiscated from a circus where she lived for decades. It was obvious that she had a clever mind of her own. Scott remembers, "You could see there was a lot of life in her. That was a big takeaway. Her feet were, of course, in terrible condition, but she had a lot of spunk and spark inside her." Some might have considered Lady a loner at Sanctuary. She preferred her own company, likely because the condition of her feet kept her from getting away from others if anything happened. But she always seemed comfortable in her own skin, and she lived her life on elephant time. She shared space with Mara and Hana at times, but seemed most at ease when she could explore the world around her on her own. She took to sanctuary life with a punk enthusiasm. She would search out the tastiest green grass in the most difficult places in the habitat. Feet be damned. When Lady arrived, we didn't know how much time she had at sanctuary. Her feet were in that bad of a condition. She beat the odds again and again, finding joy in a ripe watermelon or the palms that flourished in the male Asian habitat she frequented. We'll miss her, but we're grateful that she's no longer in pain. We will never forget the lessons she taught us along the way. I'm going to be reading a few of the tributes that you guys left. We all have very, very similar feelings about Lady, so I tried to pick some to give it a good representation of who she was and what she meant to everybody. Laura B. says, "I always wanted Lady to play a more integrated role in the elephant community at GSE. But now I realize how much effort it took her to just manage her pain and live freely. In her own way, I believe she contributed to the herd, and she knew she was part of a group living relatively autonomous life. I believe she enjoyed every second of Global Sanctuary and the exquisite care she received, and I'm grateful she had this peace and freedom, and thank you for all of your incredible efforts to give her these years of freedom." Barb S. says, "Rest in peace, gorgeous lady. My heart is shattered, but at least you are no longer in pain. Your life at Sanctuary was all too short, but you packed a lot in. I'll miss you forever, and you always have a place in my heart. I love you, lady. I hope you find Ramba, Gita, and Pocha, and look after each other. Goodbye, beautiful lady." Sue says, "Oh, Ladybug, I am devastated. I loved you from the start, as did so many others. Thank you for teaching me about courage, spunk, and truly living each day, finding joy in sanctuary life, despite the unimaginable pain you must have endured. You're now in heaven with your herd sisters and free from pain. Run free like the wind, sweet girl. You will be forever missed, and there will never be another like you." Bill S. says, "My heart is broken with this news. Knowing that this was going to happen doesn't make it easier. It was so easy to love Lady. Her spirit will endure with me. Finally, I'm happy that she's no longer in pain." Deborah O. says, "My beloved Lady girl, I will miss your presence on my screen like no other before you." Rui R. says, "I was lucky to watch the arrival of Lady to Sanctuary and how she progressed there. How she enjoyed the new conquered freedom of choice. Her wanderings through the sanctuary grounds, savoring every bit of her new conquered freedom. It's easy to feel anger at the causes of Lady's ailments, but that affect so many other elephants, brought about by the scourge of captivity for the pleasure of humans. but it is so much better to remember how she enjoyed her life at GSE Brazil. Nanette S. says, "Lady, what can be said about you? You had a special aura about you that people fell in love with. Your name was truly appropriate for you. You were delicate, proud, and so, so gentle. I fell in love with you the first moment I saw you, and you were totally beautiful in every way. How I wish you could have had many, many more years at the sanctuary, but you knew when it was your time. You will always be in my heart, never to be forgotten. Lady, you have no more pain to endure. Fly high and run free. I will miss seeing your cheeky face, which you had when you felt good. I will always love you, beautiful girl." Anne says, "I want to say poor lady, but those words are not the right words. I love to hear the updates on Lady, specifically because she was a bit of a loner, like many of us humans are. She was so amazing. Obviously, she loved her new world and was determined to stay in it as long as she could, despite the pain. I think she came to Sanctuary to teach us all that things can get better and to fight until the end and enjoy the journey." Bernadette J. says, "Gone with grace, a true lady to the end. Rest now in eternal peace." Joe B. says, "Lady was one of a kind. She was a girl after my own heart, a loner and a rebel. She lived on her own terms. I'm so excited she was able to spend her last years in Sanctuary Paradise." Leslie R. says, "Dear Miss Lady, gone is your earthly presence, but your kind and gentle soul, spirit, lives on in all of our hearts forever, especially mine. Whenever I was having a bad day, I would comfort myself by reading stories about you because I really related to you. Your quiet and solitary demeanor spoke to me. I thought, if Lady can have a good day, well then so can I. Now my beacon of light is gone. You're free now. No fences, no painful joints, just freedom to be the lady you will always be. Rest now, gentle one. You are loved forever." I think that is all I have. Thank you, everybody, for coming today and enjoying Lady's chronological moments at Sanctuary as witnessed by the team, as documented on our blog. Almost everything that I used today was said, spoken, or written by Kat, Scott, caregivers, and the rest of the team. I think you guys did a lovely job with the tributes. Lady will always be missed, but I think if she could speak, she would want us to take a piece of her strength and carry it forward. So I hope you all find a way to do that. And thank you so much for being here with me.
Thank you.